Yes. Was it worth the wait? Hi, everybody. This is Mr. Duncan in England. How are you today? Did you see what I did there? I made a topical joke. So here we go. It is Friday afternoon. Oh, my goodness. What a week. What a week we have had here in the UK. It has been an unbelievable week. Can you see the expression on my face at the moment? This is the face of a person who can't believe all the things that have happened this week in his country. It has been a very busy week here in the UK, to say the least, for certain reasons that I will talk about a little bit later on. So how are you? How are you doing? How is it hanging? That has to be the most important question I can ask you today. How is it hanging? Is it hanging okay? How has your day been so far? How has your week been? How has March been? Has March been a good month for you? Because we are now coming towards the end of March. April is just around the corner. Can you see? April is coming soon. And with the new month, there will be lots of special things coming your way as well. Lots of super duper things coming right here on my YouTube channel. I will tell you a little bit more about that later on. I don't want to give too much away because it's not my style. So a little bit later on, I will be giving you some big news about what is happening in April. Something amazing. As if this week hasn't been busy enough already. We've had so many things going on. I have had a busy week. It's a kind of special day today because this is the 65th live English stream that I've done. So 65 now I have done. Also, can you believe this week I recorded my 500th YouTube video. It's true. So this week I posted my 500th YouTube video, and this is it. This is the one that I posted this week. So there it is, my YouTube video this week that I posted, all about April Fool's Day. So there it is. It is available on my YouTube channel at the normal speed. So that is my 500th YouTube video, and I posted that a couple of days ago. So there it is. If you want to catch it, it is available on my YouTube channel. What a busy week it has been here. I tell you now, it has been such a busy week. Besides that, also, I am about to reach another landmark with one of my video lessons. One of my video lessons is about to reach 1 million views. Of course, I have many YouTube videos that have already reached 1 million views. So this week, another one of my YouTube videos, the new version of Lesson 1, should, over the next few hours, reach 1 million views. Don't forget, the original version of my Lesson 1 video has now reached 11.7 million views. That's just one video. So just one of my YouTube videos has actually reached over 11.5 million views. So the new version of Lesson 1 should, over the next few days, reach 1 million views as well. Going over that magic million mile mark. It feels like a million miles anyway. What else has been going on this week? Well, besides my new lesson, we have also discovered a new food fad this week. This is my new food fad. This is the thing that at the moment I am going absolutely crazy over. I don't know if you're like me, if you are the same as me, but I like to try new fads. A fad is something that you do for a short time, or something you discover and start doing over a long period of time. So at the moment, my current fad is poached eggs on toast. And there you can see that is actually a picture of last night's supper. That is what I had for tea last night. I had a poached egg on toast. So that is what I had to eat for my late supper yesterday. And that is my latest fad. Do you have a food fad? Is there a type of food that you like to eat? Sometimes we have little fads. Shall I write the word down for you? Because I'm very generous. I don't mind. F-A-D. So, if you have a fad, it means you have a new habit, something you enjoy doing again and again. Maybe it's a certain type of sport, or maybe a habit that you have just started. It is a new fad. Perhaps you have just started a new exercise regime. We can also describe that as a fad. At the moment, I have a new food fad, which is eating poached egg on toast. And of course, if you want to cook your poached eggs properly, the egg has to be soft in the middle. You can't have it hard, okay? So the yellow part must be soft. That is the sign of a good poached egg, apparently. And as I mentioned earlier, it has been a very busy week here in the UK. You know why. This week, we officially said goodbye to Europe as the UK signed Article 50, which will release us from the European Union. Although, having said that, even though they've signed the piece of paper, we still have to wait for another 2 years before it becomes official. So we still have to wait for two more years before the UK and Europe part company properly. I suppose in a way we are still part of Europe, but we aren't part of the European Union. So that happened this week on, was it Wednesday, wasn't it? It was Tuesday. They took the piece of paper across to Brussels on Tuesday, and it was announced officially on Wednesday. So there it is. We are now no longer part of the European Union. Does it feel any different? I'm not sure, really. I don't feel any different. Maybe in 2 years' time, perhaps in 2 years' time, I will be feeling a little bit different. But at the moment, I can't feel any change at all. So this week, we said goodbye to the European Union. Also this week, something happened in the UK. Do you know what it is? Something new appeared this week. No, it wasn't Angela Merkel's new hairstyle. It was, in fact, a new coin. A new British coin was released this week. The new pound coin. There you can see the old pound coins. There they are, looking all old and tarnished. So there are the old pound coins, but now we have a new pound coin. It was brought into circulation this week. It is now available, even though I couldn't find one. I had a great deal of difficulty getting hold of one, so I haven't got a new pound coin for real because I couldn't get hold of one. But here it is, in photograph form. This is the new pound coin. What do you think of that? Of course, it isn't that large. It's much smaller than that, because you'd never be able to fit that in your pocket, would you? No. So there it is, the new pound coin. On the left, you can see the front view. So that's what the new pound coin looks like on the front. You can see the rose and the thistle and the leek. They are all symbols of England, Wales, and Scotland. And of course, on the end, you can see the clover, the young clover on the end, which of course represents Ireland as well. So there it is, the new pound coin. And on the right you can see the Queen's head, and underneath you can see very small writing. In fact, I don't think you can see it on the screen, but there is very tiny microscopic writing going around the edge of the coin. Apparently this coin is unforgeable, so it's virtually impossible to copy this particular coin. You can't copy it, so this one is forge proof. It means it cannot be copied. So there it is, the new pound coin, and it has quite a few sides. In fact, is it 12? 12 sides. Let me just count just to make sure. Yes, it has 12 sides. What do you call a 12-sided object? I'm asking myself that question, by the way, because I don't know. So there is the Queen's head on the right, and on the front, you can see on the left, rather, the front of the new pound coin. How much is the new pound coin worth? Well, maybe in 2 years' time it might be worth 26p. I'm not sure. But at the moment, £1 is worth 100 pennies. But I'm not sure how much it'll be worth 2 years from now. I'm not sure. Who knows? So there it is. Lots of big news coming out of the UK this week. How are things where you are? Are things okay? I hope so. I hope you've had a great week, and I hope you've had a brilliant March. Don't forget, tomorrow it's the first day of April. April has arrived, or will arrive. For some people it's about to arrive, and for others we have to wait for a few more hours yet. But April is just around the corner, and of course on April the 1st people like to play pranks, and they like to hoax each other with April Fool's jokes. So tomorrow is April Fool's Day. If you don't know what that's all about, you can watch my YouTube lesson, What is April Fool's Day? And it is available on my YouTube channel right now. And it's also my 500th YouTube video. I can't believe that I've now uploaded 500 YouTube videos. In fact, this particular live stream will be video number 501, because if you miss this, or if you miss some of it or all of it, you can watch this again later. So this particular live stream that you're watching now, later on, will be my 501st YouTube video. And this is live English number 65. I can't believe I've done 65 of these. Or this is my 65th today. Coming up later on, lots of things to talk about. I've already been talking for 15 minutes. Coming up at 3 o'clock today, I will be going into my kitchen. It has become quite a tradition now for me to go into my kitchen and make myself a hot drink at 3 o'clock. I will be doing that again today. I will be going into my kitchen to make a hot drink. What will the hot drink be? Find out. Also, during that moment, I will be sharing some big news. There will be a very big announcement coming today at 3 o'clock concerning my YouTube channel, and also the month of April. So something very special will be happening in April. And it's all to do with my English lessons. What will it be? You will have to stay tuned and find out. All will be revealed at 3 o'clock today. Also, I like to ask you questions now and again. I just asked you a question, by the way. Do you know what a 12-sided object is called? Perhaps you can tell me later, because I don't know. Also, I'm going to ask you what this means. You can see two words there. They are used in modern English. But what do they mean? What do they mean? You often see them typed on the internet. You often see them in text form on the internet. What do they mean? There they are. Can you see them? They're very clear on the screen. What do they mean? This is for the young people. I think all of the young people will get this right. I don't mean to be ageist there, but if you are young, there is a good chance that you will know what these two things mean. So there they are. You will have a chance to let me know later because I will be going live. Yes. Did you know that? Were you aware that you will have a chance to say hello to me live in around about 10 minutes time as we go live on the live chat? So you will have a chance to type your messages to me and I will have a chance to answer you, to give you a reply. The weather this week has been rather nice. Spring has definitely arrived. I will be going outside a little bit later on. Shall we have a look outside at the moment, just to have a look, see what's going on? Let's go outside and have a look. So that's the view today. Look at that. Isn't that beautiful? So there I will be a little bit later on, giving you some flash words and some flash phrases as well. So there is the scene at the moment, live in my garden. The sun is out, although there are quite a few clouds around today. So now and again, the sun does go in behind the clouds. But it's a beautiful day here today. Although this morning it was raining. Can you believe it? This morning it was actually raining outside. Talking of spring, let's have a look at some close-up shots of spring, shall we? Because I don't know about you, I love spring. Spring and summer, they are both my favourite seasons of the year. So let's have a close look at some of the spring views. Now, these are things that I filmed in the garden this week. Oh, look at that. Can you see? There is a view of my cherry blossom tree. As you can see, all of the cherry blossom has come out. So this tree is now in bloom. When we say that something is in bloom, it means that the flowers have come out on that particular bush or tree. And there is a close-up shot. Oh, look at that. I love cherry blossom so much. In Japan, they actually have a special season for cherry blossom and a festival as well. So people in Japan get very excited when the cherry blossom comes out because all of the trees look magnificent. They have huge areas of cherry blossom trees, and when they all come out into bloom, they look quite magnificent. And of course, spring would not be spring without some daffodils. The daffodils in my garden at the moment are looking quite magnificent. They are now at their peak. I would say that the daffodils are now blooming at their peak. Quite a few daffodils. I love it when they sway in the breeze. I love it when the breeze blows the daffodils from side to side. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. And you can hear the bird song as well in the background. Absolutely gorgeous. Some close-up shots now. A couple of daffodils. The one on the left looks like it's starting to wither away. Oh, I don't like that. I don't like it when the flowers start to wither and die. I must admit, I don't like that. It always makes me feel a little bit unhappy. I always feel a little sad when the flowers start to die away. And this particular flower, this is a large bush called a forsythia. Forsythia. And at the moment, this particular forsythia is in full bloom. You will notice that during springtime, many of the flowers are yellow. I don't know why. Some more daffodils now. you have some white daffodils in the distance. And around the edge, you can see some lovely yellow daffodils. These are all shots taken in my garden this week. Oh, look, a little wasp. A wasp cleaning itself. Can you see? That wasp is now cleaning itself. A little wasp in my garden. Lots of wasps and bees buzzing around at the moment. These are all shots filmed in my garden this week. And there it is, a nice close-up shot of a wasp wasping around. You probably know already, but wasps can sting more than once. But if a bumblebee stings you, it dies. That's not very nice. You may have noticed already that I love nature very much. I am a big fan of nature. And there is a shot taken looking out towards the Shropshire landscape. And some birds, if you look towards the centre of the screen, you will see a big flock of crows flying across. If you keep watching, they will come back in a second. Here they come, yes! A large flock of crows flying in the distance. Very nice. So there are some springtime shots. I hope you enjoyed those. Something different to start off today's live English. And of course, you can watch my live English and you can listen at the same time. So there's always something to see and always something to listen to on my live English lessons. We are now 4 minutes away from the live chat. Now, let me just explain something very briefly about the live chat, because one or two people got a little confused last week. There is a feature on the live chat called Super Chat. If you see this symbol on Super Chat, do you know what this means? Do you know what it means? It means that you can donate money live on the live chat. If you want your message to be prominent and seen by everyone on the live chat for a long time, you can actually make a small donation on the live chat. Now, I do realize that YouTube hasn't made this available everywhere. For example, in Vietnam, it isn't available yet. But in many other countries, you can use it at the moment. I know that in Japan and most of Europe, the UK, the United States, Australia, I know that the Super Chat is available. So if you'd like to make a little donation to help this work continue, because of course I do all of this for free, this costs nothing. So now you are watching me give my time for free. Talking of which, it is National Kindness Day today. Have you ever done anything kind for someone else? Or has someone ever done something kind for you? So today is National Kindness Day in the UK. So if you would like to be kind today, maybe you can make a little donation on the Super Chat when I open the live chat any minute now. In a few moments, I will be opening the live chat. Coming up a little bit later on also, I will be showing you some clips from one or two of my YouTube videos, including Ask Mr. Duncan. Who remembers Ask Mr. Duncan? Can you remember it? It was a program I did quite a few years ago now, and it was a show where I just answered your questions one after the other. And originally it was weekly, and then eventually it became monthly. So later on, I will be showing you a clip from one of my Ask Mr. Duncan lessons, and they are available on my YouTube channel. They are all available there to watch. So that coming a little bit later on as well. So here we go. As the clock approaches 2:30, 2:30 in the afternoon, I don't know what time it is where you are, whether it's morning or evening or afternoon, Perhaps you are just waking up. Maybe you are just going to bed. Maybe you are going to sleep with Mr. Duncan on next to you. That's nice. I think. Maybe. Let's open the live chat because 2 o'clock, or should I say 2:30, is now here. That's it. The live chat is now open, up and running for you to say hello live. Don't forget, we have the super chat as well. I know it isn't available everywhere, but we do have the super chat. If you wish to make a little donation on the super chat, you can. You have to click that button on the chat. So it is Friday the 31st of March. April is just around the corner. I have some great news coming a little bit later on. In half an hour, I will go into my kitchen to make a drink, a hot drink. And whilst in there, I am going to reveal some big news. The live chat is now up and running. What do you call a 12-sided object? Because the new pound coin has just come out. There it is. So there it is, the new pound coin. It has 12 sides. What do you call a 12-sided object? Is there a name for it? Simona is here. Hello, Simona. Welcome to the live chat today. Julie is here. Hello, Julie. Tuan Phong says hello. I think you are watching in Vietnam. Anzonic is here. Welcome back, Anzonic. Mitra is here with an exclamation mark. Hello there. I like it. Rika is here. Hello, Rika. Good afternoon, Mr. Duncan. Nice to see you again. Hello, everybody. Hello, Mr. Duncan. It's great to see you. Thank you, Eugene, for that. Thank you for saying hello. Sue Mann says, hi, Mr. Duncan. I am watching in Pakistan. A big hello to you as well. It's always great to see my regular viewers, but also new viewers as well. So if it's your first time here today, please let me know. Trung Tiu Quang says, Mr. Duncan, what do you think about Brexit? Saturino is here. Hello, Saturino. The new pound has 12 sides. And it is a dodecanono. That doesn't sound right, does it? Is that true? A dodecagono. I don't have to name 12-sided objects very often, can you tell? And I'm sure you don't either. That's a great... I'm going to write that down. Can I just write that down? Because it's a great word. It's a word I've never come across. And I teach English, for goodness sake. Dodecagono. Or gono. Do. That is brilliant. It almost looks as if it has too many vowels. There it is, too many vowels there, but there it is. Dodecagono or dodecagono or gono. I'm going to guess it's gono. I don't think it's gono. Dodecagono. I know there's tristidecaphobia, which is the fear of the number 13. So there it is, a 12-sided object. The new pound coin is a dodecagono. I'm sure someone is going to say, "Here, Mr. Duncan, you've got the pronunciation wrong, you stupid idiot." It's not very nice. Hello, Mr. Duncan from Italy. Francesco is here. Hello, Francesco. Welcome. Khalid also names the 12-sided object. Thank you very much for that. Hello, respected teacher, says Salah Ahmed. Hello to you as well. Thank you very much for joining me. Francesco is watching in Italy. Hello to you. I've got an itchy nose. Excuse me. Itchy nose. I think I've got a bit of hay fever today. Mr. Duncan, it's lovely to watch your lessons, says Sophie Poet. Thank you very much and welcome. Welcome along. Don't forget, this is live on a Friday afternoon. It's now 25 to 3 o'clock. At 3 o'clock, I'm going into my kitchen to make a hot drink, but also I have some big exciting news to tell you as well. I have some big news. Diego is here. Catherine is here. And Borgia is here watching in Spain. Last week, someone wrote to me and said, Mr. Duncan, you never say hello to Spain. Now, I think I've said hello to Spain many times in the past, lots of times. But a big hello to Spain. Hello to everyone watching today in Spain. Serif is watching in Turkey. Hello to Turkey. I have actually been to Turkey. In fact, a little bit later on, I am going to show you a video clip from one of my Word Stop episodes. And the beginning was filmed in Turkey. That coming a little bit later on. Also, I will be showing you an excerpt from one of my full English lessons and also Ask Mr. Duncan as well. So much coming up today. I have a feeling I'm not going to be able to do all this today. I don't think I'm going to have time. Also, what does this mean? What does this mean? This is for the young people. I think young people will get this one. What does it mean? Two things there written down. What do they mean? Hello from Libya. Hello to Libya. And that is Safar Boka. Hello to you. Hi, Mr. Duncan. I think all of the world is here. Hello, world. Yes, I have people watching all around the world. So many countries. Look at all of the places where I have viewers. A lot of countries around the world watching my English lessons. Don't forget, you can catch my YouTube channel all the time. All of my lessons are free. Many, many countries watching around the world. And of course, this week I posted a new YouTube video. Tomorrow is April Fool's Day. It's April the 1st tomorrow. And I have made a lesson all about April Fool's Day. And it is available on my YouTube channel. Mr. Duncan, Carl Najuan asks, Mr. Duncan, when is your birthday? My birthday is on August the 12th. The 12th day of August is my birthday. So it's a little way off yet. Rita, Mr. Duncan, congratulations on your 500th lesson. You are incredible. Thank you for helping us from Brazil. You are welcome, Rita. And here's to another 500. If I live that long. Sarah. And Deborah. Sarah and Deborah, hello to you. Thanks for joining me today live on Mr. Duncan's Live English. Victoria is here. Mr. Duncan, do you ever read the comments under your videos? Yes, I do, all the time. Every morning when I wake up, the first thing I normally do is go to my computer and I check my comments. So every morning I do that without fail. Attila says, hello, Mr. Duncan. Hi to you as well. Lots of people joining me today. A very big audience. Thank you very much. Mr. Duncan, Hanau Jui says, how are you today? I'm super, thanks. And Fedredeen says, hello to the world. And the world says hello to you. Simone says, hello from Poland. Hello, Poland. I know that I have lots of viewers watching in Poland. Lots of Polish viewers. Daniela says, Mr. Duncan, my birthday is also on the 12th of August. What a coincidence. Fancy that. Simona has also said hello again with the answer to the question. This is something you will see a lot on the internet, quite often on sites where people stream games. So if they are playing computer games and they are chatting at the same time, quite often you will see these two words used. Now, it's very interesting that these are not words that are used in speech. They are often used in text. I will reveal the answer later on. Mr. Duncan, I think today you will make a cup of coffee. Is that what you think? Okay. I will be making a cup of coffee in around about 20 minutes from now. So you still have a little bit of time to wait. Hello from Egypt. Hello to Hoda, watching in Egypt. Thank you for joining me today. Mr. Duncan, hello to you from Israel, says Lev Takencho. Chakenko. Sorry if I mispronounce your name there. I will just say hello to Lev, watching in Israel. A big hello to you. Mr. Duncan, where did you live before you moved here? I used to live in a large city called Wolverhampton. And before that, I lived in the place I was born, which is Stafford. And of course, don't forget, for 4 years, I lived in China, working and living overseas in China. That is something I did for many years. Hello from India. Hello to Nidhi Didi. I love your name. Lara says, hello from Tarit in Morocco. I did mention Morocco last week, and during the week I had lots of viewers watching me in Morocco during the week. Now, I'm not sure if it's because I mentioned Morocco last week, but it is a country that I've always wanted to go to. I've always been fascinated by it. Jamal says, Mr. Duncan, I am Jamal from Morocco. Oh, another Moroccan. Lots of people in Morocco watching at the moment. Marjal says, Mr. Duncan, greetings from Barcelona. Thanks a bunch for your help with English. You are very welcome. Let's have a look at a clip now. We are going to have a little look quickly at a YouTube video. This is a series of videos I made quite a few years ago called Ask Mr. Duncan. And this is taken from number 17 of my series of Ask Mr. Duncan. And this is a special one because this was made during the World Cup. So it was made a few years ago now when the World Cup was taking place. I won't tell you anymore. I will let the video reveal everything. Football, the World Cup is here. Football, football, pass me another beer. Football, football, playing on the pitch. Football, football, losing such a... Hang on a second. I don't even follow football. Excuse me, let me put this right. That's better. Hi, everybody. This is Mr. Duncan in England. How are you today? Are you okay? I hope so. Are you happy? I hope so. Here I am once again with another selection of your quandaries, queries, and comments concerning English and my work here on the internet. So without any more hesitation, let us have our first question for today. How important are collocations in spoken and written English? This email comes from Victor Huaman, and the question comes from his girlfriend, Beatriz Lopez. They both live in Peru.
A collocation is normally made up of two or more commonly used words. It is probably easier to give examples of them rather than explain all the details. Collocations may feature words such as make or do, make a drink, do the washing up. From these examples, you can see that collocations often express a verb or an action. Something is done. It has been done. It has been done in a certain way. The words find, save, come, see, feel, do, make all occur in collocations. So it would be useful to know how they should be used in both writing and speech. Common mistakes may occur when learning English, and the various collocations often become mixed up and confused with each other. So to answer your question, yes, collocations are very important.
We're not going to have the full English just yet. Hold your horses. So there it is. That is Ask Mr. Duncan from 2010. That was Ask Mr. Duncan number 17, talking all about collocations. I hope that was helpful to you. Back to the live chat, because we are now 14 minutes away from going into the kitchen to make a hot drink. Will you be doing that as well? Mr. Duncan, we have all watched Ask Mr. Duncan. It is super. But the 21st video is not available. It is marked as private. Oh, I wonder why. I don't know why that is. I know I did have a problem with some of my Ask Mr. Duncan lessons where I think it was copyright. Because you know that YouTube quite often will punish people if they infringe someone else's copyright. So that might be the reason. I will check that later today. Hello, Mr. Duncan. You are very funny. I hope you are all okay. We are all okay. I'm fine, even though the UK has now left. It's left the European Union. I'm sorry. I'm a little bit emotional today. I'll be fine. Don't worry. But we did leave the EU this week. We signed Article 50, and now we are leaving the EU. Mr. Duncan, you have a very beautiful garden. How do you look after it in such a lovely way? Lots of hard work. It must take a very long time to put everything right. Hello from France, says Pierre. A big bonjour to you, Pierre. Thank you. Jack is here. Phrasal verbs are different types of sentences that express something, but not literally. Not literally. Mr. Duncan. Mohammed Tabib says, hello, Mr. Duncan. I am Mohammed from Algeria. Hello to you as well. And a big hello to Algeria. I know I have lots of viewers there because during the week, I like to look at where people are watching me. So on my YouTube page, I can actually go into the background and all of the information concerning who is watching and where they are watching. So I know which countries are following me. I know which countries are watching my videos. I know how many people are here today even. Mr. Duncan, what is your main source of income? I normally sit on a street corner with my hand opened out like that. Only on Tuesdays though. Ariel Smith says, Mr. Duncan, what is your main source of income? I think I just answered that one. Mr. Duncan, will your program be every Friday? Yes, I am here every Friday, live every Friday from 2 p.m. UK time. So next Friday, I will be here. The Friday after, I will be here. The Friday after that, I will be here. So every Friday, 2 p.m. UK time. No problem. There it is. 2 p.m. UK time every Friday. Mr. Duncan, can you say hello to Vietnam and Khan? Khan is my name. Khan Nguyen. Hello to you. and hello to everyone watching in Vietnam. I know I have a lot of Vietnamese viewers watching at the moment. Mr. Duncan, say hello to Saudi Arabia. Geed D. Hello, Geed. Hello to you. And thanks a lot for saying hello all the way from Saudi Arabia. So what does this mean? These are actually two words here. We don't normally use them in speech, but we do use them in writing or in text, especially young people. Young people quite often use these phrases. What do they mean? I have a big announcement to make at 3 o'clock concerning my YouTube videos. Don't forget, something very big, something very important coming at 3 o'clock when I go into the kitchen. And it's something to do with April. Something very special that is happening in April, because April is coming. It's on the way. In fact, tomorrow is the 1st of April. Hello from Iraq, Mr. Duncan. I am super, thank you. And you are sending me some love as well. Oh, thank you very much. In the UK today, it is National Kindness Day. So has someone ever done something kind for you? What was it? Has anyone ever done something good for you? A kind deed, a generous action. Mr. Duncan, what an amazing way of teaching English. Thank you. I am French. Usama, hello to Usama, and you are very welcome. Don't forget, I'm here every single Friday. 9 minutes to go. I am going to make a hot drink at 3 o'clock. What will you be doing? Mr. Duncan, do you have any plans to visit Vietnam? I get asked this question many times. Many times. I don't at the moment. I don't have any plans because I'm very busy here doing my live lessons and also my recorded lessons as well. So my work keeps me busy all the time. And I have a strange feeling that in April, I'm going to be even busier. I have a very busy month coming up. So no, not at the moment. I have no plans to visit Vietnam at the moment. Sarah says, hello, Mr. Duncan. We come from Italy and we are two new followers. Oh, hello, Sarah or Sarah. Who is your friend then? Because you said there are two of you. So who is the other person? Reka says, I can't wait for your announcement, Mr. Duncan. I'm so excited. Ooh, me too. And I know what it is. CF says, hello, Mr. Duncan. What is the difference between do and make? If you do something, it's normally an action. If you make something, it's normally a creation. So an action and creation, that is the difference. Tiago says, Mr. Duncan, I can see you are using the English uniform with those flags. It was very funny. Oh, you mean in my Ask Mr. Duncan clip? Yes, it was rather funny. And as I have told you many times, I don't follow football. I don't really follow sport at all. Mr. Duncan, are you an English hooligan? No, I'm not. You'll be pleased to hear. Hooligan. That's a great word. A hooligan means a person who behaves badly. They behave violently in an antisocial way. So a hooligan. Another word we can use is lout. Lout. So you can say lout or hooligan or vandal or a person who is antisocial. They behave in an antisocial way. They are a hooligan. But not me. Can I just make that quite clear? I am not a hooligan or a lout or a vandal or any of those things. Quang Vu says, Mr. Duncan, please say hello to the Vietnamese coders. Oh, I see. There you are, busily coding away. Don't forget the cosines. Mr. Duncan, can you tell me how to listen to English every day? How to listen? Well, listening is quite a simple thing to do, but doing it for a long time is not so easy. So you do need to listen to a lot of English, listen to it on a regular basis, daily. And of course, you can listen to something, you can read something, you can do both at the same time. For example, maybe you are watching a movie with subtitles. So sometimes you can read and listen at the same time. In fact, it's very useful to do that. Mr. Duncan, April Fool's Day is not popular in Asia, so we don't actually know much about this custom. Well, that's okay, because there is a YouTube lesson that I made all about it. There it is, look. So that is my latest video lesson on my YouTube channel. And it's also my 500th video, telling you all about April Fools. So you can find that on my YouTube channel. And there is the address just behind me. There is my YouTube channel address. Just another 4 minutes to go, and then I am going into the kitchen. Mr. Duncan, I think I've answered that question already, unless you have repeated it. Not a Vivid says, Mr. Duncan, is hooligan the same as douchebag? That's a very, very interesting question. Douchebag. Now, douchebag is normally an insult given to someone that you think is stupid or idiotic or a fool. What a douchebag. It's often used in American English, but of course we use it here as well in British English. So if someone is a douchebag, it means they are a fool, they are stupid, they are an idiot, they are... What a douchebag. Mr. Duncan, my computer is lagging today, so I can't enjoy your live stream. Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. I'm very sorry about that. There is nothing I can do to help, unfortunately. After 3 o'clock, I will be going outside into the garden to give you some flash words and flash phrases. And in 3 minutes, I will also be going into another room in the house, the kitchen, to make a hot drink. Mr. Duncan, you must throw a bone. Is it something similar to Dunktober? No, it isn't. It isn't the same. No, I can rule that out straight away. No, it isn't. Thank you, Rika, for that. By the way, that's a great idiom. If you throw a bone, it means you put an idea forward. You suggest something. So if you throw a bone, it is an idiom. It means to suggest something or to put an idea forward. That's a great one. Thank you, Rika, for that. Mr. Duncan, can you please explain about Brexit? How long have you got? I think it would take me the rest of today to explain what Brexit is all about. So let me try and put it simply. Let me put it in a simple way. Ah, here we go. That's what it means. There it is. I can actually illustrate everything by using just one picture. So there it is. There is the UK. So the UK is going another way, and they are leaving the European Union. So there it is. I think that picture explains everything quite clearly. So that saved a lot of time, that has. So basically, the Brexit means Britain exit. So they have joined the two words together to make Brexit. So this week, the UK officially signed the piece of paper that means now the UK is leaving the European Union. So that's it. Just another minute to go, and then I'm going into the kitchen. So please bear with me. What will I be drinking today? Will it be something hot, something cold, something sweet, or perhaps something savoury? Ooh. Is that a clue? Am I giving you a clue there? Perhaps. Mr. Duncan, you are the most natural teacher of English in the world, mister, compared to other English teachers here on YouTube that are so fake. You are number one. Well, of course, this is live, so none of this is fake. It's real. This is me. What you get is Mr. Duncan. What you see is what you get. So this is live. It doesn't come much more natural than this. Okay. I'm very excited now because it's now time to go into the kitchen. It's now time to make a hot drink because we are approaching 3 o'clock. And every week on a Friday, I always like to go into my kitchen to make a drink. Are you ready to join me? Are you going to make a drink as well? I hope so. Let's go. Oh my goodness, it's so bright in here. Ah, yeah. Turn it down a little bit. Okay, there we go. The sun has just come out. It's very bright outside. But the problem is today, there is a lot of cloud overhead. So sometimes the sun comes out and sometimes it goes in. So I have to keep manually controlling my camera. So please bear with me. So here we go, it's 3 o'clock and it's time for me to have a break. Now, normally I have tea at 3. Last week I had coffee, didn't I? Oh yes, of course, I had coffee last week. This week I'm having something completely different. Can you guess what it is? Here we go. Today's drink is not tea, it isn't coffee, it isn't even herbal tea. Today, I am going to have some soup, some tomato soup for my 3 o'clock treat. Okay, you can have whatever you want. You don't have to have soup. You can have tea if you like, no problem. So, the next thing I need to do is open this tin of soup. Fortunately, this particular tin has a little thing on the top, a ring pull. Can you see that? So there is a little ring pull on the top. We call that a ring pull. So we don't need a tin opener. We can just use our finger to open the tin with the ring pull. Here we go. It's not easy to do, actually. They don't make it easy for you. Here we go. Right. That's good. So far, so good. I was expecting the soup to squirt everywhere, but it didn't, thank goodness. Okay, so that's the tin open. There it is. Look at that lovely tomato soup today. I'm having a drink of soup. Now, first of all, I need my super duper saucepan. Where is my saucepan? Where is it? Let's just get my saucepan. I love this saucepan. This must be my all-time favourite saucepan. I don't know why. But this particular little pot or saucepan is very, very useful. I use it for everything. In fact, last night I cooked my poached eggs in this actual saucepan. Over to the stove now. I do wish the sun would make up its mind if it's coming out or staying in. It's very annoying. So I will now pour the soup into the saucepan. There we go. So that's all the soup in the saucepan. I will now gently heat the soup up. Now, the secret is not to let it boil. You should never boil anything that has come in a tin, including baked beans and tinned soup as well. You should never boil it. All you need to do is to gently heat it. So don't let it boil, whatever you do. To help my soup heat up, I need a spoon. So... oh, yes. Here it is, my lovely big spoon. I love this spoon so much. It's very useful for stirring things, and you can beat burglars over the head with it. So you can use it as an implement and also as a weapon as well. So, we will let the soup heat up slowly, but of course there is an announcement that I have to make, a big announcement. Can you see over there? There is the piece of paper stuck to my cupboard door and it says, big announcement. There is a big announcement coming right now. As you know, April is just around the corner. I have mentioned it already today. And as a way of commemorating the fact that April is a brilliant month, because normally during April, spring starts to spring everywhere. So as a way of celebrating the arrival of April, because April is a beautiful month, I thought I would do something special. But what is it? What is the special thing that I'm going to be doing? Here it is. During April, I will be doing something very special. I will be doing not one, but two live lessons every single week during April. And here are the days. Da-da-da-da. I will be live on Tuesday and Friday. So, live on YouTube on Tuesday and Friday during April. So, only April. And here are the all-important times. First of all, on Tuesday, I will be with you at 4 p.m. UK time. So, every Tuesday during April, you will be able to catch me on YouTube on Tuesday at 4 p.m. UK time. That will give other people a chance to catch my live stream. And of course, as usual, I will be with you on Friday at 2 p.m. UK time. So Friday remains the same. So during April, I will be on YouTube not once a week, but twice a week on Tuesday. I'm doing such a good job of this. Tuesday and Friday. I hope you can see those. Tuesday and Friday. So Tuesday, 4 p.m. UK time. And on Friday at 2 p.m. UK time. So during April, I will be on YouTube twice a week. Oh my goodness, I can't believe it. Will I be able to do it though? Without suffering a load of stress? I don't know. We will have to wait and see. Find out at the end of April if I'm able to do twice a week for 4 weeks. So there it is. So you can catch me on Tuesday, 4 p.m. UK time, and on Friday at my usual time, 2 p.m. UK time. So during April, you can catch me on Tuesday and Friday. So don't forget, that's just during April. So that's the big announcement. I hope you are happy, because many people have asked, Mr. Duncan, please, can you do more live lessons? Maybe you can do two a week. Well, during April, I will be doing two live English lessons every week, just for April. Back to the soup now. Let's just make sure that it's not boiling. Don't forget, don't boil your tinned products. You must heat them up gently. In fact, it says it on the tin. It says, do not boil on the tin. Gently stir the soup to make sure that it heats up evenly. La 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 la, making some soup on a Friday afternoon. I don't know about you, but I like to add a little bit of pepper to my soup. I like it to have a little bit of a kick. So I always like to add a little bit of pepper. That is heating up nicely. That is almost ready to drink. Now, some people think that soup is a drink, whilst other people argue that soup is a meal. I'm not sure. What do you think? Is soup a drink or a meal? Or maybe it's both. If you just joined me, this is Mr. Duncan in England in his kitchen at the moment. I am making a little afternoon drink. Normally I have tea, or sometimes I have coffee. Today I am having tomato soup. Okay, I think that is ready now. I think it's ready. Now this cup is too small. I need something much larger. That's better. I've got my big 50 and fab mug. So now all we need to do is to put the soup into the mug and I am ready to drink it. Or is that eat it? Do you eat soup or drink soup? Okay. I think that's ready now. I'm about to do something very disgusting. Okay. There it is, some lovely hot soup, ready for me to drink or eat. Look at that. Very nice. Oh, wow. There it is, my cup of tomato soup. Please let me know what you are having, just in case you are having a drink at the moment. I'm now going back into the studio to slurp on my soup. Okay. I nearly spilt my soup then. I nearly spilt it everywhere. Oh my goodness. I ran in here so quickly, I almost spilt my soup everywhere. Oh my goodness. It nearly went all over my carpet. Now that wouldn't have been very clever, would it? Oh, okay. Sorry, I'm out of breath. Just give me a moment, please. Okay, I've got my soup here. What have you got? Have you got a cup of tea or a cup of coffee or something cold maybe? Back to the live chat. Let's just have a quick look at the live chat. Lots of things going on. Oh, I see. You have all been chatting away whilst I've been in the kitchen. Mr. Duncan. I think I am an advanced user. I watch your videos at 25 speed. Oh, I see. So you speed my videos up because your English is so good. I know what you mean. Thank you, Anzonic, for that. Hello, Mr. Duncan. How are you? I'm super duper today. A very busy one today. I've just been in the kitchen to make some soup. I almost spilt it everywhere. Hello, Mr. Duncan. Fatima, hello to you as well. Thanks for joining me. It's a very busy one today. Mr. Duncan, I've just woken up. It is after 7 a.m. here now in British Columbia, says Antidon. Hello, Antidon. Welcome. I've just been in the kitchen making some soup today instead of tea. Normally I have tea or coffee, but today I thought I would have something different. A little bit of soup, even though it's quite hot at the moment, so I can't drink it right now. Mr. Duncan, thank you very much. Ariel Smith, thank you as well. Ah, yes, did you get my big announcement? Did you see it? I hope you didn't go away and miss it, because the big announcement is that next week and also the week after, in fact, for the whole of April, I will be live on Tuesday and Friday. You can catch me live on YouTube on Tuesday and Friday during April. So on Tuesday, I will be with you at 4 p.m. UK time. And of course, on Friday, the usual time, 2 p.m. UK time. So during April, you can catch me twice a week live. How am I going to do it? How am I going to survive the whole of April? Mr. Duncan, I think a chef would be useful to you. That would be lovely. I wish I was wealthy enough to have my own chef. Wouldn't that be nice? I could just ring a little bell. Ding-a-ling-a-ling. And then the chef would come to me and I could order my food. That would be very nice. Thank you, Agnieszka, for that. Thank you, Agnieszka, for that comment. Puria says, bon appetit. Bon appetit. It is a polite way of saying, enjoy your food. Have a good meal. Wow, Mr. Duncan, twice a week. I can't believe that we will be seeing you twice a week live. Attila, it's true. You got it straight from the horse's mouth. Straight from the person who is involved. That's me. Mr. Duncan, soup is a meal. I suppose soup is a meal. Yes, that's right. Some people think it's a drink, though, because you can see here today I'm drinking my soup. So is soup a drink or a meal? I'm going to try some now. It's very thick. It's starting to cool down now. Very lovely. Mr. Duncan, I think that soup is a drink, says Perea. Oh, I see. Okay, Perea. Perea says it's a drink. Mr. Duncan, have a good appetite. Yes, I will, definitely. Eugene says, I am very excited about the live streams on Tuesday, and especially about the time. It is even more comfortable for my schedule. So Tuesday, 4 p.m. UK time, live on YouTube. And of course, on Friday, 2 p.m. live on YouTube. And that is during April. Twice a week. Wow. Trung Tiu Quang says, honestly speaking, I do love having pepper in my soup. Me too. I love pepper. It really livens up the food, I think. I like pepper on everything, even on vegetables, especially if I have vegetables like cabbage. I always put a little bit of pepper on the top. Ah, gorgeous. That's actually very nice. Mr. Duncan, soup can be a drink or a meal because it contains both solids and liquid as well. At the moment, I am drinking coffee, says Lagel. Oh, I see. Yes, I suppose it can be both. Of course, there is a type of soup that's very thin and watery, and that we normally call that broth. So there is soup, which is normally very thick, and then there is broth, which is normally very thin and watery. Mr. Duncan, it is now holiday in this part of the world, says Fatima. Oh, happy holiday to you today then. Mr. Duncan, is your soup good? It is very tasty, very nice, and I think the pepper is perfect. Very lovely. Mr. Duncan, you have an orange moustache. What? Oh, I see. How disgusting. I'm very sorry about that. Oh, goodness me. I seem to have soup all around my mouth. And I don't have a tissue. I don't have anything to wipe my mouth with. Oh, my goodness. That's not very good, is it? Mr. Duncan, yummy tomato recipe. You can get a big slice of brown bread and put some garlic on it and then put it on the tomatoes with olive oil. Oh, I see. Do you toast it? Do you put it under a grill and then toast it? That sounds very nice. I mean, I like garlic anyway. I'm a big fan of garlic. Love it to bits. Mr. Duncan, we can't believe that you're going to be here twice a week. Yes, during April, I will be here twice a week.
Twice a week?
Definitely. Mr. Duncan, I like your English program. Mr. Duncan, you have red lips. I think it's the soup. I think I have some soup on my lips. It looks like I've got an orange moustache. Mr. Duncan, what is your main job? My main job is teaching. I teach English. I also make videos. I do lots of things, really. I like to keep very busy. Would you like to see a little bit of one of my Ask Mr. Duncan? Not Ask Mr. Duncan, full English. Full English lessons. We had a clip from Ask Mr. Duncan earlier. So now we are going to have a clip from one of my full English lessons. And this is taken from full English number 2. Have you ever been caught doing something red-handed? Have you ever been caught in the act? The idiom red-handed means that you have been caught in the act of committing a crime or doing something wrong. You might have been seen carrying out the bad act as it was being done. Or perhaps some evidence was found that showed you doing it, such as a photograph or video clip. You have been caught red-handed. You were caught red-handed. The phrase originated in Scotland and refers to the bloodstains found on the hands of a murderer. As a child, I used to play many games, but one game in particular still sticks out in my mind. Hide and seek. I bet at some point you have played this game too. The game is almost always played by a group of people. One person hides, and the other people must try to find that person. We can use hide and seek as a phrase to mean the task of trying to hunt for someone. If a person keeps escaping from your view as you pursue them, then we can describe this as a game of hide and seek. We can also say that the people involved are playing cat and mouse.
the pursuer and the pursued, the runner and the chaser. To search for a person who is missing or in hiding can be described as a hunt. Grammar is probably the hardest part of English to grasp, so I have decided to take some parts of English grammar and look closely at each one. For each full English episode, there will be one grammatical element to look at. Today, we will look at sentences. English sentences fall into four types: the statement, the question, the order or request, the exclamation. The statement is a sentence that gives information. To state is to say, and quite often saying means giving information. The car is travelling very fast. The boy looks very unhappy. These are statements. If information is being given or an observation is being made, then we are making a statement. To question something means we make an inquiry. We need information, so to get it, we must first put forward a question. If you want to find out something, you will almost always ask a question. To investigate something always involves asking questions. Is that car going too fast? Did you see where that man went? Can you hear the plane flying over Mr. Duncan's head? To give an order or make a request is to ask for something to be done, or not to be done, or to demand something. Don't be so rude. Don't drive so fast. A request can be in the form of a question, but in this case, information is not required. To ask someone to do something or tell them is an order. It is a request. An exclamation is a sentence that shows surprise or shock. It is often used to show anger or rage. You cheated on me. How fast that car is going. Oh, what a mess. An exclamation can also be put forward in the form of a question. The most common form of sentence is the statement. This is because most sentences pass on information. Conversation normally involves parting with information or making comments, which themselves are statements.
Ooh, that was delicious. And the excerpt you just saw, the clip, was from one of my full English lessons. There are lots of full English lessons on my YouTube channel. Among many other video lessons, this week I uploaded my 500th YouTube video onto my YouTube channel. So now there are 500 YouTube videos on my channel. There is the address over there. Apparently, Mr. Duncan, could you please check your lips? Saturino says, Mr. Duncan, you have Donald Trump mustache there. It looks like Donald Trump's hair is growing on your top lip. Yes, I think I have some tomato soup on my top lip. Just one moment. I've just got a little bit more to drink. Just one moment. Hmm. That was very, very delicious. I must say, I might do that next week. I might have some soup next week, or maybe something else. Perhaps instead of making a drink, I could make a meal. Perhaps. Don't forget, I will be with you twice a week during April. You can catch me twice a week during April on Tuesday at 4 p.m. and also on Friday at the usual time. I will put them on the screen so you can see. There we go. So during April, I will be with you on Tuesday at 4 p.m. and on Friday at 2 p.m. UK time. So during April, I will be with you twice a week. Oh my goodness. But don't forget, it's only during April. So Tuesday, 4 p.m. UK time, and also on Friday, the usual time, 2 p.m. I hope that's okay. Something special to celebrate the month of April, because April is a great month. Normally, the weather gets better and it starts to feel more and more like summer. So that's why I always get very excited. I get very excited in April. Mr. Duncan, are you going abroad this year? I don't think so, because I'm so busy here. It doesn't look as if I have time to do any traveling this year. I have so many things I want to do. Mr. Duncan, you can also add some basil in your soup. That's a very good idea. Okay, I've finished my soup now, by the way. It's finished. Just one more little drop left. Wow. That was very nice. And now, because many people are complaining about it, I will now wipe my mouth. So I now have some tissue paper here. So let me just wipe my mouth so I don't look like a child of five. Mr. Duncan, you eat your food like a baby. There we go. That's better. Is that okay now? Have I got everything? Am I presentable again? Good. That's nice to know. Yep. Mr. Duncan, please lick your lips. Watching your video, I want to come and visit you, says Ariel Smith. Oh, I see. Really? Okay, then. Mr. Duncan, I can feel your positive energy, says Min Tu. You are always funny. Could you share how you keep being so optimistic? I did mention this last week. I did talk about my optimism and the reason why I'm always so positive about things. And that's because I always feel quite happy when I wake up in the morning. I'm always relieved to see that I have another chance to live for another day. So it always seems very special to me in the morning when I open my eyes and I realize that I get to do it all over again. So that's the reason why I love life. Life's pretty good. As I always say, it's better than the alternative. So yes, I like to keep optimistic and positive even when things seem a little gloomy. Like at the moment here in the UK, because this week it was decided, it was signed, it was sealed, and it was delivered. The agreement to leave the European Union, it is now going to happen definitely. Although we have to wait for 2 years for it to actually happen. Mr. Duncan, we have the same kind of soup here in Turkey, says Allah Edin. Hello, Allah Edin. Thank you very much for watching, and a big hello to Turkey. I actually did make quite a few lessons in Turkey. I made a series of lessons about words in Turkey, and also I made a lesson about going on holiday in Turkey. So I have been to Turkey twice. Mr. Duncan, watching your videos, I can see that you are full of the joys of spring. Tiago Varela says, oh my goodness, I had to go out of the room quickly, and when I came back, Mr. Duncan had an orange moustache. What happened? It's okay, I was drinking some soup, but now it's all gone now, you see. I've drunk it all. It's gone. Shall we go outside? Because one or two of you have said, Mr. Duncan, please go outside. We want to see you in your garden. So, okay, no problem. Let's go outside, shall we? Yeah. We are now going outside. As you can see, the sun has disappeared again. Doopy-doo. Oh dear, the sun has gone in. Where has the sun gone? Suddenly the sky is very dark and gloomy. Oh dear me. I was just saying that things are gloomy in the studio, and things out here are quite gloomy as well. So here we go. We have a flash phrase. Is that okay? For a Friday afternoon, here is today's flash phrase. It is beat about the bush. Beat about the bush. Beat about the bush is an English phrase that means to delay getting to the point of something. If you talk and talk without making any point or giving any useful information, we can say that you are beating about the bush. For goodness sake, stop beating about the bush and tell us why you are here. I don't have much time, so please don't beat about the bush. You can also say beat around the bush, which means the same thing. The phrase derives from the action of disturbing or beating a bush while hunting game birds. So there it is. Beat around the bush or beat about the bush. It is today's flash phrase. Did you see it? One more time? Okay. So now I'm in my garden live. It is now 3:36 in the afternoon on Friday. And you can see at the moment all of the flowers are coming out. We have daffodils. Even the blossom on my damson tree. So the damson tree is now coming into blossom as well. So the garden is looking very, very colourful at the moment because spring has arrived. Okay, I'm back. I'm back in the studio, but this time I didn't run because I didn't want to fall over. Whew, that's better. I'm back indoors now. Although it looks like it's about to rain. It's gone very, very cloudy and dark. Oh dear. Mr. Duncan, do you teach in a school or only on the internet? All of my work now is through the internet. I spend a lot of my time producing English lessons, and of course I spend a lot of my time teaching English live, like now. Mr. Duncan, I appreciate your new look. It is very stunning. I think you are referring to my orange moustache. It's gone now. Mr. Duncan, happy 500 videos. Yes, this week I reached a very special milestone, a very special point in time, because I reached my 500th video. The video all about April Fool's Day is the video. There it is. So the video with me explaining what April Fool's Day is now available on my YouTube channel. And of course, tomorrow is April Fool's Day. Of course, not everyone celebrates or observes or plays the April Fool's tricks. So not everyone does it. Mr. James, can I come and visit you? My name is Mr. Duncan. What happened... Oh, the live chat is moving very quickly today. Mr. Duncan, you are very funny and intelligent. I like watching you prepare food and then eating it. Well, there are people who will pay to watch other people eat food. I think it's in South Korea. I'm sure it's in Korea that there are people who will pay other people to eat food on a webcam. Mr. Duncan, your garden is very beautiful. Thank you very much for that. 20 minutes left. Today's live English has gone very quickly. Even I can't believe it. Mr. Duncan, at the world clock, it seems 20 minutes less than the one you hang on the wall. Really? Well, this is the time now. This is the time now. It is now 20 minutes away from 4 o'clock, 20 minutes left of my live English stream. So yes, this is the time in the UK at the moment. Mr. Duncan, your garden is like a place where fairies live. Thank you, Eugene. Antidon, wow, your garden is spectacular. It is very nice at the moment because, of course, we have all of the flowers and the trees. Everything is coming to life. That's why we call it spring. Mr. Duncan, I am following you from Palestine. I love your lessons, says Ahmed. Thank you, Ahmed, for following. Don't forget, everyone is welcome wherever you are in the world. You are all very welcome to my live English lessons. I did see a message earlier about kindness, but now I can't find it. Let me just see if I can find it. It was quite an interesting message. Now I can't find it. Where is it? I think it may have disappeared. Yes, I did see a message earlier about somebody doing... Ah, here we go. True Tiu Quang says... Mr. Duncan, you are talking about kindness because today here in the UK it is National Kindness Day. When my house was invaded, lots of people got my family out to safety and they fought with the burglars, but they didn't even want a donation. Oh, sorry, they even did give a donation to help us out after the robbery. I remember one of them was actually a foreigner. Oh, maybe British or American, I don't know. So thank you, Trung, for that. It is National Kindness Day today. Has anyone ever done anything kind for you? And if so, what was it? Mr. Duncan, congratulations on your 500th video. Thank you very much, Antidon, for that. Yes, my 500th video. And today, this is Live English number 65. Don't forget also, I have been making YouTube videos for over 10 years. So I started making English videos way back in 2006. So I have been here on YouTube making English lessons for over 10 years now. Wow. Mr. Duncan, what do you think about Scotland leaving the UK? That is a very contentious issue. A lot of people are getting very angry and heated because, of course, England and Scotland for many years were enemies. We used to fight all the time. So hopefully things will stay the same, but who knows? Who knows in this crazy, unpredictable world that we live in nowadays? Mr. Duncan, do you think that Scotland... Oh, I think I just answered that one. Mr. Duncan, why didn't you get married? Well, you'll be amazed how many people don't get married. It's not compulsory anymore. So here in the UK, if you don't want to get married, you don't have to. There's nobody telling you to get married. You don't have to. It's not the law. Families don't care. They don't care if you get married or you don't. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter at all. Mr. Duncan, how are you? I am from Brazil. Angalod. Thank you very much for saying hello and a big hello to Brazil. Saturino, I have a little garden too. Now it's a forest. I think it needs some trimming. You need to trim your garden. You need to tidy it up. Mr. Duncan, what does void mean? Void, that's an interesting word. Let me just find a clean piece of paper. Void means an expanse of nothing. So nothing, if something is empty, if there is nothing around, an empty space, we can describe it as being a void. Void. So there it is, an empty space that seems to go on forever. Void. I hope that helps you. You have done some very kind things all over the world. You have made free live English videos. Thanks a lot for that. Don't forget, everything you see here is free. It costs you nothing. But of course, if you wish to make a kind donation, you can click on the little button. The little button, if it works, sometimes it doesn't work, for the super chat. Mr. Duncan. Do you ever quench your garden yourself? When you mean quench, do you mean water? Sometimes I will go into my garden and I will water the garden. I will put some water onto the garden, especially the grass, because during the summer the grass will become very dry. So I do sometimes water the garden. But having said that, over the past few days, it's been raining quite a lot. So at the moment, the garden is very wet. Mr. Duncan, do you think that "Are you lost in the echo" can be a metaphor which you can use to talk about questions that need time to answer, but you are unable to find the right one? Are you lost in the echo? It's not a common phrase. I must admit, I've never heard it used, ever. Borgia. Borgia. Hello, Borgia. Mr. Duncan, do you have any children? No, I don't. I don't have any kids. So, a few years ago, I made a series of English lessons called The Word Stop. Now, this is where I talk about one particular word in each video. And then later on, I started making videos featuring two words. So let's have a look at the first ever word stop. And as I mentioned earlier, this was actually made during my time in Turkey. Words, words, words are everywhere. Those lovely words we love to share, like pleasure and measure, hope and joy, giggle and wiggle, light and toy. Words can delight, words can destroy. Words all have meaning, of this we are sure. So use your words carefully, or one day, perhaps, your words may cause harm, hurt, or a string of mishaps. Today's word is ample. The word ample is an adjective that means something is easily available and not in short supply. There is more than enough of it. There is ample parking in town. An ample supply of fruit can be found here. The house has ample room for us to move around in. We can also say the amount is more than sufficient, or more than we require. Synonyms of ample include abundant, enough, plentiful. A, M, P, L, E. Ample. So there it is from one of my word stop lessons. Now, the word stop is a series of lessons where I feature individual words and then explain them. So there was the first ever one. And at the beginning, did you see the part at the beginning with me talking to camera with my poem? That was filmed in a place called Kash. Not Kash. That's another part of Turkey. It was actually filmed near a place called Fethiye, which is in Turkey. So I have in the past done some filming in Turkey, and I've always had a wonderful time whenever I've been there. Back to the live chat, because we only have 10 minutes left. Today's live English has gone very quickly, I must admit. It's gone very quickly. Mr. Duncan, April the 2nd is the World Day for Autism Awareness. My son is autistic and he loves to see his classes. Thank you, Rita Maria Gomez, for that. And of course, a lot of people this week have been talking about the condition of autism. It is still a thing that is misunderstood by many people. And of course, because autism is not just one individual thing, it's actually many things on a very wide spectrum. So yes, autism is being talked about a lot this week, and on April the 2nd it is World Autism Day. Mr. Duncan, did you switch your stove off? I think so. I normally do. I'm very good at remembering those sorts of things. Hello, Mr. Duncan, I'm following you from Algeria. Nice job. Hello, Mr. Duncan, I am crying because Mr. Duncan ignores me. Lucy, I'm sure I said hello to you earlier. I'm not ignoring anyone. I try to include everyone if I can. Mr. Duncan, hello from Turkey. Oh, hello. Did you see me just? I was in Turkey a few moments ago. Adiyak Kumar says hello from India. Hi to India. Don't forget next week, something very special happening next week. And throughout April, I will be with you twice a week. I will be with you live on Tuesday and Friday during April. Tuesday, 4 p.m. UK time. There it is. UK time, 4 p.m. on Tuesday. And of course, as usual, on Friday, 2 p.m. UK time. You can catch me twice a week during April. So I will be with you. I will be with you live on Tuesday and Friday. Don't forget, this is just for April. So I will be with you next Tuesday. Wow, at 4 p.m. UK time with another live English stream. So during April, you get me twice a week. Mr. Duncan, I am going from Piotra and Irene. They both say au revoir, which means goodbye. By the way, the word void, I mentioned void earlier. Void can also mean to empty something, if you empty something. So to empty or to be empty. So it can be a thing or it can be a sort of action as well. So you can actually have it as an action. For example, if you go to the toilet, for a number two, you normally void your bowels. Ugh. And void can also mean worthless or useless. If something is invalid, something that can't be used, it is void. It has been cancelled. It is now worthless, useless. It is void. Have a nice day. I am from Brazil. Thank you, Agnaldo, for that. I am going in 6 minutes. Oh my goodness, today has gone so fast. Mr. Duncan, could you do a word stop in Guatemala? You can stay for free at my house. Guatemala is the best place and it is cheap for travel. I've never been to Guatemala ever in my life. Thank you, Ruby, for that. Thank you for your offer. Very kind of you. Do you think we have time to go outside very briefly? Okay, let's go outside very quickly and then we will say goodbye. I don't want to. I don't want to say goodbye. I want to stay here all night, but I can't, unfortunately, because I have to go back into the kitchen later to make my supper. Let's go outside once again. It's beautiful outside. Oh, can you see the pheasant? Hey, look, there's a pheasant in the garden. Live, look. There it is. Can you see the pheasant? The pheasant is just behind the... But there it is. Did you see the pheasant? Now, that pheasant is now live in the garden. So that is now a live picture. I don't know where the pheasant is. But if I go to the window, if I go outside, he will actually fly away. Okay, I'm going outside now. Don't forget to look out for the pheasant. Bye-bye, Mr. Pheasant. Bye-bye. Did you see that? The pheasant came into my garden. Oh, that's so cute. Okay, here we go. Just before I finish, just another 4 minutes to go, and then I am going to say goodbye. So today's final flash word. Here it is. Onus. Oh, that sounds like something else. Onus. The word onus. Thank you. That was the pheasant saying goodbye. Did you hear that? The word onus is an English noun that means the responsibility or duty that lies with an individual or group. A requirement to do something is the onus. Onus names the personal burden, responsibility, or accountability that must be acted on in some way. You must admit your wrongdoing. The onus is on you. The onus is on him to come forward and testify. Something you feel is your duty or obligation to do or carry out is the onus. The word onus means burden, responsibility, obligation, duty, requirement, weight, a cross to bear, a milestone round one's neck. So there it is. Something you must do, something that is your responsibility to do, is the onus. Onus. Interesting word, that. Right, I'm going back inside now. I'm coming back in to say goodbye. And also, I think the pheasant wants to come back as well. Oh, I must say it's a very busy one today. Very busy. Did you see the pheasant? Did you see it? Wasn't that funny? Okay, I am going now. It's coming up to 4 o'clock. I've had a very busy day today. It's been a very busy week here. Wow, Mr. Duncan, what a lovely garden. Thank you, Lagelle. Mr. Duncan, thanks so much for your lessons. They are very useful. Thank you, Luciano. Do you look after the garden yourself? Well, it takes two people to take care of the garden. Two people. There is a lot of work to be done out there. That's great, Mr. Duncan. Koaho, thank you very much for that. Good week. Have a good weekend, Mr. Duncan. All the best for you. Yes, later on, I am going to have a lovely curry tonight. As usual, always on a Friday evening, I have a nice curry. Ooh. Mr. Duncan, have a nice weekend, and we enjoyed your videos. Thank you very much. Hipster. Hipster. I like that. Just before I go, this means to own or ownage. So if you win or beat someone, if you are the victor or the winner, you have ownage. Ownage. You own someone. Now, the reason why it's spelt with a P is because quite often when you are typing, people who type words beginning with O, they accidentally press P instead. So that's the reason why it's spelt with a P. So these words are often used in text only. So that's what it means. So to own or ownage. And the reason why it's a P is because quite often people press P instead of O. So that should be own and ownage. I hope that explains it all. Thank you, Mr. Duncan. I really enjoyed it. It was very useful. Have a great weekend. Thank you, Mitra. Thank you, Simona. Thank you, Elena. Thank you, Ramon. Thank you, Quang Vu. The Quang Vu. Quang Vu and the coders all say goodbye and have a great weekend with your coding. Thank you very much. Have a great weekend. Rika, Peter Lynch, Raoul, and everyone who has joined me today. Don't forget, I am back with you next week because we start a little bit differently next week with the new month. We are going to be here on Tuesday and also on Friday as well. So I will see you next Tuesday. Don't forget, Tuesday, 4 p.m. UK time. Thanks for the live lesson, Attila. Thank you very much, Attila, for that. Hamdi, goodbye, Hamdi. Parting is such sweet sorrow, but don't worry, I will be back on Tuesday, next Tuesday. This is Mr. Duncan in the birthplace of English saying thanks for watching me today. Have a great evening, a great morning, a great afternoon, wherever you're watching. Have a super duper weekend. And don't forget, I will see you on Tuesday, 4 p.m. UK time. Have a great time, won't you all? And of course, you know what's coming next. You know what's coming next. Ta-ta for now.